Students, good morning. How are you? I hope you are doing well. And in the previous class, we had studied about the first portion of our fourth chapter, A Message from the Sea. Which is our fourth chapter? A Message from the Sea. What is the meaning of message? A verbal, written, or recorded communication is called a message. It may be a verbal communication, it may be a written communication, or it may be a recorded communication. Nowadays there are so many ways to send messages, email, through internet we can chat with others, and so many ways to communicate with others. In the olden times there was only messages, and these messages were sent through messengers. The person who is carrying the message is called messenger. M-E-S-S-E-N-G-E-R, messenger. I'm telling this just for your information. And here is a message from the sea. That means our nature has provided us plenty of resources. Nature has provided us plenty of resources. And nowadays human beings, that means we people are not utilizing it properly. We are disturbing the nature. We are polluting the nature. As a result of that disturbance, nature is turning towards us. Nature is turning towards us. And in the previous years, we had seen so many floods. And so many people lost their lives in that floods. Okay, that like that, the nature is turning towards the human beings. Nature is turning towards the human beings. If we hurt them, if we spoil the nature or spoil the natural resources. Which are the natural resources? Water, sunlight, then trees, that are air, that are natural resources that nature or God has given us in plenty, and we are not utilizing or using it properly. We are not using it properly. And here in this story is a message from the sea. The message. Message means it is a message for human beings from the sea. Sea means, what is the difference between two seas are there? That is, in the previous class I discussed about that. S-E-E-C and S-E-A-C. What is the difference in meaning? These two words or grunts are same, and the spelling and meaning are different. That kind of words are called homophones that we later in you study in your higher classes. That means this C means we see a flower. We see a flower. We are seeing with our eyes. That is this C. And this is ocean. O-C-E-A-N. Ocean. C means ocean. Then Tini and Mini were twins. In the previous class we discussed it, but I am reminding you by reading this text and explain the meaning. Tini and Mini were twins. Twins means two children born together to a single mother is called twins. Two children born together, born at one time to a single mother is called twins. Tini and Mini were twins and they lived in an apartment. What is apartment? Apartment is a suite of room in a tall building. There were so many, simply we can say it is a flat. They were living in a flat and in the posh area of South Mumbai. Where are they living? Mini and Tini are living in a posh area in South Mumbai. Posh area. Posh area means where the upper class people are living. An area in which the upper class people are living in is called a posh area, posh area. It is a posh area. And Mini and Tini are living in a posh area in South Mumbai in an apartment. They are living not in a house, they are living in an apartment. They are living in an apartment. And their skyscraper apartment had 22 floors. Their skyscraper, they are going to touch the sky. That means skyscraper. That apartment has 22 floors. 22 floors, we are having a house of one floor. And at least we see a building with two floors or even three floors. But they are here, Mini and Tini are living in an apartment, and their apartment is a big building. Their apartment is a skyscraper building. That means it is going to touch the sky. It has 22 floors. It has 22 floors and they live on the 18th floor. They are living in a flat in the 18th floor. They are living in a flat in the 18th floor, and they lived in the 18th floor. The view from the balcony was wonderful. The view when they look from their balcony, when they look out through their balcony, sitting in their balcony, it was a beautiful sight. It was very wonderful. The sea glittered when the sun rays fell on it. What was the sea? What was the sight? The sea glittered. Glittered means it is shining. When it is shining, when the sun rays fell on the sea, fell on the water, surface of the water, the sea is glittering. When the sun rays fell on the surface of the water, the sea is glittering. When the sun rays fell on it, sometimes they could even see a big ship on the horizon. Looking from their balcony, they can see, sometimes they can see a ship in the horizon. Horizon means, what is the meaning of horizon? Chakravala. Horizon. When the meeting place of the sky and the land is called the sea. The sky and the sea is called the horizon. The meeting place of the sky and the sea is called the horizon. They can see a horizon, far away horizon. They can see ships in the far away horizon. Even they see big ships on the horizon. They loved to go to the Juhu beach on weekends. Where is Juhu beach? Where is Juhu beach? In the previous class I had taught you that. Where is Juhu beach? Juhu beach in South Mumbai. Juhu beach. Juhu beach. J-U-H-U-B-E-A-C-H. Juhu beach is in South Mumbai. South Mumbai. Juhu beach is in South Mumbai, and they like to go to Juhu beach, or they used to go to Juhu beach on weekends. Today the teacher taught them about the importance of throwing rubbish, the importance of throwing rubbish into the dustbin, and also the disadvantages of using plastic things. Today's portion was about the disturbances that was made by throwing dust or waste in the surroundings. The disadvantages of throwing waste in our surroundings. You always throw the waste and rubbish only in the dustbin. The teacher told us to throw the dust and waste in the rubbish and the waste. Rubbish means waste. Rubbish only in the dustbin. Use dustbin. Always use a dustbin. Don't make the place messy. Rubbish in the dustbin, and also the disadvantages of using plastic bag. Nowadays we are using paper bags and eco-friendly bags. In before times, we use so many plastic bags. Food items are kept in plastic containers that are not good for our proper health. The disadvantages of using plastic bags. The teacher taught us the disadvantages. Advantages means benefit to us. Disadvantages, not beneficial. There are so many disadvantages of using plastic bags. She had also told them about the danger of plastic to marine animals and the congestion in the sea. Some factories are throwing wastage and dump their waste through drainage into the rivers and oceans. That will cause danger. That will be very dangerous to the marine animals. Marine animals. What is the meaning of marine animals? M-A-R-I-N-E. Marine. Marine means living in the water. Marine means living in the water bodies. It will cause, the dumping of wastage will cause danger to the marine animals, and there may be a congestion. There may be a congestion in the water. There may be a congested situation in the water. It is not a congestion means there is not enough space to move freely. That is congestion. The dumping of wastage, huge amount of wastage dumping in seawater will cause congestion to marine animals and suffocation to marine animals in the sea. She warned them that if they will not take care of the environment, if human beings or if the authority will not take care of the environment, what will happen? Nature would take a bad turn. Nature will tend to us. Nature is providing us with so many things, and if we are not using it properly, and if we are doing harm to it, if we are doing harm to the natural resources, the nature will turn to us. If we are doing natural, if we are doing harm to the natural resources only, if we are not using it properly, nature will turn towards us. As a result of the nature's contempt, it will come to us in the form of flood, etc. Flood, not rain, etc. After dinner, they went into bed. Who were the twins here? Mini and Tini were the twins. And after dinner, dinner means the food we take at night is called a dinner. The food we take before going to bed is called a dinner. There is one another word for that, supper. S-U-P-P-E-R, supper. After dinner, they went into bed. Mini could hear the waves. Hear the waves means, what is the meaning of Mini could hear the waves? Hear the sound of the waves. There may be, if there are huge waves, we can see louder sounds. If that is huge waves, we can see louder sounds. If it is calm, see, there may be, sometimes there may be calm sea, and sometimes there may be wild sea. If it is a wild sea, there may be huge waves and the sound is also very high. The sound is also very high. Mini could hear the waves. All of a sudden, it grew dark. It grew dark in the night. The waves grew gigantic. Gigantic means it is a big, like a big creature. The huge waves, there were huge waves. Gigantic waves means very big waves. Gigantic means very big. The waves grew. Grew means grow. The waves grew gigantic. No, there was no water in the waves. There was no water in the waves. The huge waves were full of rubbish. They saw on the beach food plates, packets of chips, empty tins, cardboard boxes, plastic bottles, glasses, and much more. What can they see in the waves? There is no water in the waves. What are the things in the waves? The things in the waves are food plates. F-O-O-D-P-L-A-T-E-S. Food plates. Next one. Empty tin. Packets of chips. Packets of P-A-C-K-E-T-S. Packets of chips. Empty tins. E-M-P-T-Y. Empty tins. Empty tins. Then cardboard boxes. C-A-R-D-B-O-A-R-D. Cardboard boxes. Plastic bottles, glasses, and much more. Plastic bottles, P-L-A-S-T-I-C. Plastic bottles, glasses, G-L-A-S-S-E-S. The things that dumped in the sea, it came to the shore. It came to the shore in the form of waves. There is no water. When we are seeing the normal sea, the water is coming like waves. There is a wave-like movement in the sea. Always there may be a wave-like movement in the sea. And the wave is full of water. Wave is full of water. But this time, the sea is very dangerous. The sea is very dangerous. Wild sea. We can see wild gigantic waves. There is not a single drop of water in the waves. Only waste products are there in the, only wastages are there in the waves. We can see only wastages in the waves. In the huge waves, there is only wastages. Which are the things in the waves? Which are the things? Food plates, plastic plates. Nowadays, we are not serving food in plastic plates. We are using only natural plates. Natural plates means banana leaves, etc. And the food plates are there, plastic plates are there. Then, packet of chips. We are, the chips and other fried items are coming in plastic containers, plastic packets. And we throw that plastic into the sea. They are dumped in the sea. And in this gigantic wave, in this night, the gigantic wave came. And there is not a single drop of water in the wave. There is only waste product in the waste materials in the wave. The waste materials are food plates, packets of chips, empty tins. The tins that we used, some materials are coming in tins and tinned food. And after using the food items in the tins, we are throwing the tins into the sea. Empty tins, then cardboard boxes. cardboard boxes, plastic bottles and glasses are there. They are not degradable materials. These things are not degradable materials. They are not degrading in the nature. They are dumped in the sea. As a result of the wastage dumping, the sea became very wild. The sea became very wild and gigantic waves are coming out of the sea. Gigantic waves are coming out of the sea. Which are the things we can see in the waves? Food plates, packet of chips, empty tins, cardboard boxes, plastic bottles, glasses and much more. So many more things. It was frightening sight. It was a frightening sight. Frightening means fearsome. Frightening means fearsome. The sight was a fearsome one. It was a frightening one. It is not a happy sight. The waves grew bigger and bigger. It almost reached the 18th floor. When we are looking from the balcony, the waves are growing in a fast rate. Growing in a fast rate, that means it is growing bigger and bigger. While we are looking at it, the waves are growing bigger and bigger. Even it touched the 18th floor of our apartment. It touched the 18th floor of our apartment. Where was Tini and Minnie living? Tini and Minnie were living in the 18th floor of the apartment, and the apartment has 22 floors. The waves were very gigantic. They could even touch the 18th floor. They could even touch the 18th floor. That means it is describing the hugeness or bigness of the waves. The bigness of the waves. Go away, Minnie shouted. Who is shouting? Minnie is shouting, go away waves, go away from us. Why did you throw the rubbish on me? Why are you throwing the rubbish on me? The waves are coming towards her. Minnie is looking through the balcony and the waves are coming towards her. The waves are coming towards her. Why do you throw the rubbish on me? Why do you throw the rubbish? What is the meaning of rubbish? Rubbish means waste. Rubbish means waste. Why do you throw the rubbish on me? Said the huge wave angrily. What is the reply of the wave? The huge wave replied angrily. Angrily means with so much anger in its voice. It is not calm. It is in an angry mood. It is in an angry mood. Keep it in your houses. Why you are throwing the waste into me? You keep the waste into your own houses. Keep it in your houses. All my married children die because of its effect. You are putting so much of waste into me. You are putting so much of waste into me. My children. Who is the children of the sea? The children of the sea are the marine animals. That means the fish, seahorse, like that. So many marine animals are there. Marine plants are there. That are the children. They were the children of the sea. And here the sea is telling in an angry mood. Why you are dumping so much of waste into me? Why you keep the waste in your own houses? You keep the waste in your own houses. All my married children die because of its effect. You are putting so much of waste into me, and due to the dumping of this waste, there is congestion inside the sea. There is congestion inside the sea, and the marine animals and the plants could not move freely inside the water. They could not move freely. There is congested state inside the water. They die because of its effect. If you humans throw any rubbish on me, I shall throw it back and suffocate you. Suffocate means suffocation. 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 Shwasamuttikuka. Suffocate means shwasamuttuka. Then if you are throwing this kind of rubbish into me again and again, if you are throwing this kind of waste into me again and again, I will return the waste towards you. I will return. Who is telling these things? The sea is telling these things. Is the sea happy? No, it is in an angry mode. The sea is in an angry mode. It is bursting out in rage. Rage means anger. R-A-G-E. It is bursting out in rage and telling Minnie. Minnie is asking the sea that, why you are throwing the rubbish on me? Are you ridiculing me? Are you throwing the, are you going to throw the waste on me? The sea told angrily, the sea replied angrily that if human beings are throwing waste in this manner, my children, that means the marine animals, die because of the effect of this waste. So if you are doing it again and again, I will return the waste towards the human beings, and I will return the waste to the shores, seashore, and that will suffocate you, that will suffocate you. Help, help, the wave will swallow me, cried Minnie. Minnie cried and goes to the inside of the house. Minnie cried out and goes to the inside of the house. What was her cry? Help, help, the wave will swallow me. Swallow means S-W-A-L-L-O-W, swallow. Always your teacher and parents will tell you, don't swallow your food, chew your food properly. What is the meaning of swallow? S-W-A-L-L-O-W, swallow means vijunuga. The sea is going to swallow me, Minnie shouted and cried. Minnie shouted and cried, the sea is going to swallow me, and you save me, you help me, the sea is going to swallow me. Okay, take the next page. Minnie, Minnie, called Tinny, get up, I think you are having a nightmare. These are the dream, nightmare means fairies of nightmare. And these are the dream of the dream of Minnie. Minnie, Minnie called out Tinny. They are in the bed, they are sleeping, and here Minnie is having a nightmare. Minnie, Minnie called Tinny, get up, I think you are having a nightmare. Listen to the spelling. N-I-G-H-T-M-A-R-E, nightmare means parisopnam. Nightmare. It may be a nightmare. You are having a nightmare. Why are you crying? You get up, get up. Thank God, today when I go to school, I shall tell the teacher about the message from the sea. Minnie thinks it is a message from the sea. We are polluting the sea by throwing rubbish into the sea. It is a message from the sea. I saw a dream in my sleep. I saw a dream in my sleep, and I consider that dream as a message from the sea. It is a message from the sea. Tomorrow when I go to school, I will narrate the dream to my teacher. It is a message from the sea. I will narrate, means describe. I will narrate the dream to my teacher and my friends, and then I will tell it is a message from the sea. All my friends should know the importance of not throwing rubbish on the beach and the disadvantages of using plastic. When I narrate or describe these things or these incidents to the teacher and my friends, they will understand the importance of not throwing waste into the sea or beach, in the beach. Not throwing waste. Don't throw waste into the sea and near the sea. That means on the beach. I will tell the importance of not throwing waste into the sea. You throw the waste only in the dustbin. You divide the waste as degradable and biodegradable, and you throw in the prescribed dustbins. Otherwise, when you throw the waste into the sea water, or when you throw the waste here and there, that will harm the nature, that will harm the well functioning of nature, and the nature will one day turn towards us. So Minnie told Tinny that tomorrow I will describe these incidents to the teacher and to my friends, and then they will understand the importance of not throwing rubbish into the sea and into the beach, and doing any harm to the nature. And there may be some disadvantages of using plastic bags. This is all about our chapter. I will read the text one or two times. You should listen to the text. You take the text, page number 32, and listen carefully while I was reading. Okay, Minnie and Tinny were twins. They lived in an apartment in the posh area of South Mumbai. Their skyscraper apartment had 22 floors. They lived on the 18th floor. The view from the balcony was wonderful. The sea glittered when the sun rays fell on it. Sometimes they could even see a big ship on the horizon. They loved to go to the Juhu beach on weekends. Today the teacher taught them about the importance of throwing rubbish into the dustbin and also the disadvantages of using plastic. She had also told them about the danger of plastic to marine animals and the condition in the sea. She warned them that if they will not take care of the environment, nature would take a bad turn. After dinner, they went to bed. Minnie could hear the waves. All of a sudden, it grew dark. The waves grew gigantic. No, there was no water in the waves. The huge waves were full of rubbish. They saw on the beach food plates, packets of chips, empty tins, cardboard boxes, plastic bottles, glasses, and much more. It was frightening. The waves grew bigger and bigger. It almost reached the 18th floor. Go away, Minnie shouted. Why do you throw the rubbish on me? Said the huge wave angrily. Keep it in your house. All my marine children die because of its effect. If you humans throw any rubbish on me, I shall throw it back and suffocate you. Help, help, the waves will swallow me, cried Minnie. Minnie called Tinny. Get up, I think you are having a nightmare. Thank God, today when I go to school, I shall tell the teacher about the message from the sea. All my friends should know the importance of not throwing rubbish on a beach and the disadvantages of using plastic. Okay, now let us move on to the dictation words. I will write the dictation words in the board. First word, apartment, A-P-A-R-T-M-E-N-T, apartment. Listen here, apartment, A-P-A-R-T-M-E-N-T, apartment. First word, apartment. Next one, skyscraper, S-K-Y, S-C-R-A-P-E-R, skyscraper, S-K-Y-S-C-R-A-P-E-R, skyscraper. Next one, glitter, G-L-I-T-T-E-R-E-D, glitter, G-L-I-T-T-E-R-E-D, glitter. Next word, horizon, H-O-R-I-Z-O-N, horizon, H-O-R-I-Z-O-N, horizon. Next word, importance, I-M-P-O-R-T-A-N-C-E, importance, I-M-P-O-R-T-A-N, C-E, importance. Next one, disadvantages. D-I-S-A-D-V-A-N-T-A-G-E-S. Disadvantages. Advantages, opposite, disadvantages. Disadvantages. D-I-S-A-D-V-A-N-T-A-G-E-S. Disadvantages. Next one, marine, M-A-R-I-N-E, marine, M-A-R-I-N-E, marine. Next one, congestion, C-O-N-G-E-S-T-I-O-N, congestion, C-O-N-G-E-S-T-I-O-N, congestion. Next one, gigantic, G-I-G-A-N-T-I-C, gigantic, G-I-G-A-N-T-I-C, gigantic. Next one, nightmare, N I G H T M A R E, nightmare. These are the words. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 words are there. I will tell you one more time. Apartment. A P A R T M E N T. Apartment. Next one. Skyscraper. S K Y S C R A P E R. Skyscraper. Next one. Glitter. G L I T T E R E D. Glitter. Next one. Horizon. H O R I Z O N. Horizon. Next one. Importance. I M P O R T A N C E. Importance. Next one. Disadvantages. D I S A D V A N T A G E S. Disadvantages. Next word. Marine. M A R I N E. Marine. Next one. Congestion. C O N G E S T I O N. Congestion. C O N G E S T I O N. Congestion. Next one. Jaijani. G I G A N T I C. Jaijani. G I G A N T I C. Jaijani. Last one. Nightmare. N I G S T M A R E. Nightmare. N I G H T M A R. These are the dictation words. You study it today itself and you write these words 10 times in your notebook. You study the words and write these 10 times in your notebook. Then let us move on to the meaning. Then rubbish. R U B B I S H. Rubbish. Meaning of rubbish? Waste material. Rubbish means waste material. Waste material. W A S T E. Waste material. M A T E R I A L. Material. Rubbish means waste material. Waste material. The next one is marine. M A R I N E. Marine means in the sea. In the sea. The things in the sea are called a marine. The fish in the sea are called a marine. Fish, marine plants, then. Marine equipments are there that in the sea, anything that is in the sea is called a marine. Marine, M-A-R-I-N-E, marine, meaning in the sea. Next one, congestion, spelling C-O-N-G-E-S-T-I-O-N, congestion, C-O-N-G-E-S-T-I-O-N, congestion. What is the meaning of congestion? Very crowded. That means blocked. They could not move freely. There is not enough space to move freely. Is called a congested area. Congestion means very crowded. Very, V-E-R-Y, very crowded. C-R-O-W-D-E-D, very crowded. C-R-O-W-D-E-D, crowded. Very crowded or blocked. There is one more meaning is there. Blocked. B L O C K E D. Blocked. B L O C CKED blocked. Next one, Jai Jani. TIGANTIC. Jai Jani. GIGANTIC. Jai Jani. Jai Jani. What is the meaning of Jai Jani? Very large. That means huge one. Very big. Very large. Very large. Very large. Gigantic means very large, very big one. Gigantic. GIGANTIC. Gigantic means very large or huge. There is one more word for that. Huge. 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 Gigantic means huge or very large. Then horizon. HORI. Is a O N horizon. 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 What is the meaning of horizon? The line at which the earth's surface and the sky appear to meet. The line at which the earth's surface. The earth surface, earth surface and the sky appear to meet, and the sky appear to meet, APPEAR, appear to meet, to MEET, meet. The line at which the earth's surface and the sky appear to meet. There is earth is there and the sky is coming from here. And here, when we look from far away place, we can see that the earth's surface and the sky meet at a point. And this point is called a horizon. And this point is called a horizon. This is called a horizon. Okay, then the last word is swallow. S-W-A-L-L-O-W. The last word is swallow. S-W-A-L-L-O-W. Swallow. What is the meaning of swallow? What is the meaning? Swallow means eat without chewing. Without chewing, when we put something into the mouth, without chewing or without any movement in the mouth, we swallow it. That means when we without chewing, if we are taking food without chewing, it is called a swallowing. Swallow means eat without chewing. EAT, eat, WITHOUT, without chewing. Eat without the chewing is called a swallow. Swallow means eat without the chewing. These are the meanings. Okay, I will tell you one more time. GLITTER, glitter. What is the meaning? Sparkle. SPARKLE, sparkle. Next one, rubbish. RUBBISH. Rubbish means waste material. WAST, waste material. MATERIAL, material. Next one, marine. M-A-R-I-N-E, meaning in the sea, in the sea, S-E-A-C. Next one, congestion, C-O-N-G-E-S-T-I-O-N, congestion means very crowded or crowded, V-E-R-I, very, C-R-O-W-D-E-D, crowded or B-L-O-C-K-E-D, blocked. Next one, gigantic, very large or huge, gigantic means very large or huge. Next word, horizon. The meaning of horizon is the line at which the earth's surface and the sky appear to meet. Swallow means eat without chewing. Swallow means eat without a chewing. Okay. Then there is some words to make sentences, sentence formation. And there is sentence formation. Sentence formation is there. Make sentences from the This is all about the meaning. And today we completed our fourth chapter. You read the text as many times as possible. That means so many times. Whenever you get time, you read the text. That will help you to learn the question answers. And we can stop here today. And let us continue in the next class. Okay, thank you.